Hey everybody, Smart Silver Stacker here. Hope you're doing well. So I just wanted to chime in today with a few thoughts on silver and the precious metals. What's ahead for these metals as we await the much anticipated Federal Reserve decision on rate cuts, the much anticipated Fed pivot that we've been hearing about for so long? Well, tomorrow's the day. So we're going to hear from Jerome Powell tomorrow afternoon. We'll see what the Fed is going to do. The big question now is how deep will the cuts be? And markets are going to be hinging on every word of these central bankers tomorrow. I just looked at the charts of both silver and gold. And right now, gold price and the silver price both coming under just a little bit of pressure ahead of that decision. Some of that has to do with the fact that there were some retail sales numbers released this morning, which were better than expected. So we do live in this bizarre world where good news is oftentimes bad news, because good news means that the Fed doesn't have as much cover to cut as they otherwise would if the data was really terrible. First off, on that retail sales number, any sales numbers that are beating expectations that seem to paint a rosy picture for the retail consumer in the United States, I think largely is just due to the fact that inflation is often underrepresented in the statistics. So consumers aren't spending more money because the economy is so great. It's just because everything's so much more expensive. And even though they might have a deflator in some of this data to kind of account for that, oftentimes it understates the real level of inflation. So it makes things look a lot better than they are. But the bottom line here is, regardless of what the Fed does tomorrow, it's not really going to change things for gold and silver, which I do view as having a very bright future, but not for the reasons that investors seem to think. I mean, we're heading into a phase here where silver is up a little over 30% over the past year. Gold is at record all-time highs, and yet the Fed is cutting here and saying that they've won their fight against inflation. And nothing could be further from the truth. And yet, that is what is driving price action in these markets. But that's actually a really good thing for you and me, for us stackers, because despite the fact that gold is at record all-time high prices and silver has been on a real tear over the past year, both of these precious metals, and especially silver, remain incredibly undervalued at today's prices. I mean, I think it's safe to say, in light of all the other asset bubbles that we've seen, in light of the stock market, the tech boom, all of that stuff, silver at $30, or a little over $30, which is the current price, is a huge sale for us stackers. And so I'm still stacking metal. If you want to stack some metal, check out SD Bullion. That's where I buy mine. Right now, new stackers can get gold or silver at spot by visiting sdbullion.com/new. So now that I've got the sponsor plug out of the way, let's just talk about what's really going to be happening for the precious metals in the coming weeks, months, and years. So right now, everybody seems to think, and I think they're buying the official line, that everything is fine in the U.S. economy. Janet Yellen tells us that the jobs market is strong. Central bankers tell us that we're into a recovery. But again, nothing could be further from the truth. We live in an economy that is built on a false premise. It's built on the premise of easy money, monetary policy, which has created enormous levels of debt. The deficits are absolutely exploding. Last month, according to the Treasury, the official U.S. deficit for the month of August hit $380 billion. If you annualize that, that's a little over $4.5 trillion. So they're spending money like a drunken sailor. Perhaps that would be, offensive to the drunken sailor. At least they earned their money, right? They didn't just confiscate it via taxation. What is likely ahead, if you ask me, is some serious economic deterioration here in the U.S. Now, we're heading into an election, and I think a lot of folks out there think that maybe there are some answers that we're going to get one way or the other in November. People think that as long as their candidate gets into office, everything's going to be fine. But the reality is that the situation we find ourselves in, where we're borrowing $380 billion a month, we've racked up $35 trillion in debt here domestically, and we've got over $200 trillion in unfunded liabilities. There's no politician in the world that can fix that unless, you know, they're going to do some very unpopular things. But we haven't heard that from either party. In fact, what have we heard regarding the dollar and the dollar's role in the global stage and what's ahead for the dollar? Well, on one side, you've got Harris. She's promising huge subsidies, tax credits for small businesses to the tune of $50,000, new homebuyer credits of, I think, also $50,000 to cover down payments, subsidies for families, for every kid. They're going to get a couple $1,000. You know, I don't know the exact policy because none of it matters anyway. I mean, the bottom line is we don't have any money to subsidize any of these things. So what's going to happen? All that money is going to be borrowed out of nowhere. And on the other shoe, you got Trump, who, you know, he's expanded the debt significantly in his previous term. At least he's not talking about this complete socialist platform. But, you know, one thing he's said is that for countries who are pursuing a policy of de-dollarization globally, and we know that the BRICS nations are working on a new currency, a potentially pegged to gold. We know that currencies like the Chinese yuan are on the rise in terms of their role in settling international payments. And yeah, the dollar is still supreme. But what Trump has threatened is any country that wants to dump the dollar, they're going to get a 100% tariff imposed on their goods, sending them to the U.S. Now, you'd think maybe that would scare countries into falling in line. But what have we seen since he made that statement? China and Saudi Arabia are talking about settling their oil trade in the yuan. In fact, it was a Saudi trade minister who floated that idea at a recent speech in Hong Kong. So it doesn't appear that they're taking the bait. It seems like countries are accelerating their de-dollarization agenda. And I don't really have a lot of faith in more threats and dollar weaponization to solve that problem. I mean, if you really want to attract people to your currency, what you need to do is get your domestic economy in order, get your debt under control, balance the budget, reduce unsustainable entitlements, and stop weaponizing the dollar via sanctions. But it doesn't look like we're going to get that no matter what. So the future of the US dollar as the world reserve currency is really coming into question here. And at the same time, you got gold hitting record all-time highs, silver on a huge tear. But how much do you hear about that in the mainstream media? You know, I did a live stream the other day. It was the day last week when gold was breaking out to new record all-time highs, a significant breakout out of a consolidation pattern. And I looked at the front page of Bloomberg, and there was not a single headline about it. The only place that the word gold appeared on the Bloomberg front page was up in the ticker at the top, where they have, you know, price tickers for various commodities and markets. It's not on really anybody's radar in the mainstream that the precious metals are on this rip, what the potential implications could be for the dollar and for inflation. I mean, everybody focuses on these government numbers, you know, the CPI, the PCE, the various measures of inflation that the government releases on its own. But the best inflation barometer of all, that is, you know, the prices that we actually pay for things. For one, if you go to the store, you know that the price of just about everything is not coming down. I mean, it's continuing to remain very elevated. It's continuing to march up. If you go to the store, if you go to eat out at a restaurant, if you buy groceries, you know inflation's a lot worse than we're being told. And gold, again, at a record all-time high. So that might be one of the best indicators of where inflation is and where it is heading. Consider this, that the Fed, in the history of the current US dollar, you know, its current form since 1971, when Richard Nixon ended gold convertibility.
I have directed the Secretary of the Treasury to take the action necessary to defend the dollar against the speculators. I have directed Secretary Connolly to suspend temporarily the convertibility of the dollar into gold or other reserve assets.
They've never before cut interest rates at a time when gold was at a record high. Usually when they're cutting, gold is relatively subdued. So the metals are about to head a lot higher. Now tomorrow, when the Fed makes its announcement, there's been a lot of speculation that there could be a sell the news type moment. Now, I don't know if that's going to happen. I don't know if the silver price and the gold price are going to fall. I don't know if markets are going to see the bottom fall out of them when the Federal Reserve makes its announcement. It probably has a lot to do with, you know, how deep the rate cut that we get is and what the Fed says at the press conference that follows the announcement. But there's no way at this point with the U.S. Treasury running a $380 billion monthly deficit, and with no end in sight to the massive expansion of government spending. In fact, probably going to get a lot more if we see a war break out somewhere, if we see geopolitical tensions escalate, if we see a real downturn in the U.S. economy. And keep in mind that, you know, just last month, it was reported that there were 818,000 jobs that had initially been reported, which, whoops, didn't exist in the first place. So all the data that we're presented with to paint this rosy picture of the economy is all doctored and cooked anyway. If we do get a major recession here, it's not like the government's going to say, well, let's cut spending and rein things in. No, they'll do exactly the opposite. As they're seeing tax receipts fall, they're going to be boosting spending to try to stimulate the economy. So if we do get a sell the news moment tomorrow and you see gold and silver selling off, I mean, I would view that as an incredible buying opportunity. But honestly, even at the prices that we're at today, especially in silver, I view this as already an incredible opportunity to acquire some hard assets that cannot be printed. Now, that doesn't mean that you want to go out necessarily and buy the SLV or a futures contract or some kind of paper derivative of silver, because those are all not real. They're manipulated. They're not backed up by enough physical metal. However, that situation whereby you have price suppression in the silver market, and maybe that's why the price of silver has lagged gold so much, that is also to our advantage. Because if we do get the kind of currency debasement frenzy that I am anticipating over the next several years from the Federal Reserve and, you know, whatever administration happens to be in office, there really becomes a strong possibility for the end of manipulation, for a potential silver squeeze, if you will, something that we've been talking about for years. But I think people have kind of short attention spans when it comes to that sort of thing, despite the fact that we've seen squeezes in things like the nickel market and the palladium market since the original silver squeeze really started to trend, and there is ample evidence that we are being set up for such a move in silver, that, you know, people kind of ignore that if it doesn't happen right away. So again, all of this is normalcy bias among your average investor. The fact that the media is not talking about the precious metals, despite the fact that the Fed is about to begin printing, it's a big advantage for those of us who understand what is going on. Now, I think a lot of people lose their patience with silver. They think, oh, you know, I've been hearing this for years. When is the price of silver going to break out? Well, I can't give you an exact date, obviously, because I don't have a crystal ball. And if I knew, I would just go buy silver with a bunch of leverage and, you know, retire as a multimillionaire. But what I can tell you is that, yes, people have been talking about a collapse in the financial system for years. It has been brewing for years, at the very least, since the great financial crisis. That's when things really went into overdrive. But I think you can make the argument that this has been in the works since 1971. And even before that, when deficit spending precluded the convertibility of the dollar into gold because there were too many dollars being borrowed and created into existence. So, you know, the roots of this crisis, which is coming, go back pretty far. In fact, you might even make the argument that they go back more than a century to 1913, to the creation of the Federal Reserve. Since that time, the dollar has become incredibly debased. And yet, yes, gold is very high, and, you know, gold has put on about an average of 8% return since 1971. I still view it as a good opportunity for gold, but silver can hardly be overstated how cheap this stuff is. And yeah, it's up 30% year over year, which is nice for those of us who were stacking before. There's still a lot of opportunity in silver. Look, it's not financial advice. Don't go out there and go all in on silver just because you heard it here. In fact, I don't recommend going all in on anything. I don't recommend anything financially. You guys do your own due diligence, everybody watching. But I just want to point out that there's a lot of attention on the Fed right now, whether they're going to cut 25 basis points or 50 basis points. But at the end of the day, none of that really matters. The fundamentals could not be stronger for the precious metals. And that's why I'll keep stacking. Leave me a comment down below to let me know what you think about everything we talked about in today's video. Stay safe and happy stacking, everybody. I'll catch you next time. Smart Silver Stacker, out.